This video is sponsored by the Epic VFX Academy. If you want to learn how to create epic VFX from A to Z, definitely check out the link in the description below to put yourself on the waitlist. All right, so we saw part one using the free standalone particle illusion software, and we have a really cool result, but now comes the time that we need to integrate those particles and make it look like a disintegration effect from the Atom projects. So let's see how that's done. All right, so now we're going to take a look at this right here. So I recorded myself on a green screen and I removed myself, which I'm not going to focus on in this video because I already have tutorials on green screen removal. And then I placed myself on another shot that I recorded in a forest. And actually it's fairly similar to the outfit transformation effect. So if you're new to this, definitely go and check out that video as well. It's definitely going to help you. So what we wanna do here is create a new solid layer, and this is going to be a white layer, and we're going to name this Luma Matte. Now we're going to uncheck this so we cannot see it, and then we want to go to our pen tool, and with the pen tool I want to draw a mask around my head. It's going to be a headshot, and then like give a little bit of a V shape into my body here, and then like again make this complete. And so honestly you can do this the way you want, and then we can enable this layer again. Now we can press M twice on the keyboard, and that will reveal all the settings for our mask right here. So we want to lower this to absolutely zero and click on stopwatch, move this to the beginning. And now we want to expand it until we cover the entire character. So now we have an animation that just grows over the entire character. And so now it's as easy as just going here and Luma inverted matte. And so now I'm getting cut off according to this mask. And so what we can do is choose this mask to move all the attributes into a new comp and just rename this mask. And so now if we jump in here, we can still focus on this mask and change it and make it look different. So what I will do is add a turbulence displacement effect. If you don't see Effects Console, this is a free plugin that I'm using just to enhance my work. But you can also go here to effects and presets and search your effects and then drag them onto your layer. So right here I have turbulence displacement, and I want to change the size quite a bit. And also the amount. And also the complexity. And like that, you're going to start creating these kind of fractures, like in a movie where it kind of disintegrates the body parts. If you want to learn how to create epic VFX from A to Z, definitely check out the link in the description below to put yourself on the waitlist. Whether you are a beginner or already have experience, this is definitely an academy where you will find a lot of benefit, whether being helped in our Discord community server, or getting feedback on your work on getting better, or just for these final little details that you need to apply in your work to finally get that A grade look in your final results. And honestly, visual effects is an up and coming career choice because of the metaverse and everything shifting into the digital. There are a lot of new and great opportunities for visual effects artists. So if you want to learn After Effects from A to Z and also want to learn how to create epic looking visual effects, then literally everything related to VFX, you can find it in the Epic VFX Academy. Put yourself on the waitlist. Let's duplicate these two layers and change the color on them. And so let's say that the bottom one is going to be shadow. So we want to choose the mask here and move a little bit into time. And with the mask selected, if we move this up, we can start seeing some depth. Obviously, the inner side should be a little bit darker. So we can click on the inner side and add a curves effect and lower the curve so we can see that this becomes darker. And so now you're going to start seeing some depth in your body, just like this. If you want, you can even add a little bit of a blue haze because we're going to add blue glow anyway later on. That's just going to add a little bit more depth in there. And so this is way too much, something like that. Okay, so now with your mask, duplicate that layer. So we're going to the mask in the project manager and we're going to duplicate this. And now it's going to be our ring effect. So we're going to open up the ring effect. And so we're going to use the Luma Matte, which in the end, it could also be this mask. So we're going to Alt drag this mask on top of the Luma Matte. And so now we have the ring with the mask being animated. So we're going to duplicate our mask and we're going to set it to Luma inverted. And now if we're going to offset this one here with one frame, we're getting this ring. And so now we have this detail here going on. That looks great. So now if we go back to our main comp, we have this ring composition that we want to drag and drop it right here. Now take our original footage with the keyed character and duplicate that and bring it on top of the ring. And now we're going to do the opposite. Instead of having this have a track mat, we want the ring to have the track mat alpha. And look at the alpha of the layer and just show that. And so now we have this ring going on here. Looks great. So now I want to add a fractal noise on top of that, and that's going to give me a little bit more detail, as you can see in this effect. So if we increase the contrast, we can see a lot of depth being created, and alt-clicking on the stopwatch and writing something like time times 200 gets you an animation like this. You can always go into the ring as well and animate the turbulence displacement effect here. So you can alt-click on this and go like time times 150. And so you're going to start creating some variation like that. And obviously, if we go back to our main comp, we now want to add some color to this. So we want to add a tint effect. And the tint effect, we want it to be blue. Pre-compose these layers as well. So this is going to be ring animation. And the reason why I did that is to add a solid composite on top of that and make it black. And then add a perfect glow, which is a preset of our website for free that you can download to add glow and to just make it look more intense. So this is just a little bit like the glow effect on steroids. You can download that for free at Creator Galaxy. So if we're going to play with these settings here, we're going to start seeing some nice glows. And so now we want to import the particles that we've created with Particle Illusion. We're just going to bring them into our composition here and set the blending mode to screen. We're going to place them right here into the center, and we can also press S and hold shift and press P, make a keyframe for these two. And we're basically just going to animate a little bit on top of that just to make it look even better. So that's great. One more thing that we need to do is choose our original clip and add an effects Mocha AE to it. So that's a free plugin that comes in After Effects. And if we click on that, we're now going to be able to planner track our footage. And I found that this is a really fun addition to track your particles onto your body while it's moving. It's going to give that extra little bit of detail here. So we're going to just select the body part, and then we're just going to track it forward. So once your track is done, we can close Mocha and we can create a new null object. So this is going to be our track, and we can place this all the way on top so we don't interfere any other layers, and click on the Mocha effects and go to the track data tab, create track data, click OK, and then choose transform here in the export option, and layer to export to is going to be our track, and then apply export. And so now if you press the track, press U, we're going to see a bunch of keyframes, which means that it succeeded. And so now we want to use our particles and track them or parent them to the track. And so now if we're going to take a look, that looks a whole lot better. And so my animation here is a little bit too fast for the ring. So what I will do is press U on the keyboard and just make this quite a bit slower. I think actually I like that, yeah. And so as you can see, we're starting to build something really cool. So now if you want, you can duplicate your particles, place some over here, rotate them slightly, and then like scale them quite a bunch, or just take new particles. That's also an option. And like offset these, maybe like that, maybe something like 40. Let's go. Maybe stretch them out just a little bit. Nobody's gonna see, nobody's gonna know.
Nobody's gonna know.
They're gonna know. How would they know?
Okay, something like that. And you can always duplicate also your original particles. What I like to do is change this to a multiply and then just invert the entire thing with a tint effect on top of it. And if I solo this, basically what I'm trying to create is an inverted black and white map. where I will now add a fast box blur and just increase the blurriness so I can now have some shadow behind my particles. So you can see that my particles are coming out a lot more. And if I add a curves here, I can even darken them up way more. And so like that, you can just add a little bit more poppiness to your particles. So that's just a little trick to add more depth to it with a simple click. And so yeah, you can duplicate it and then offset it even more, or like go like this. We just have a problem here with this mask, so we need to animate this depth map. So we're going to press P on the keyboard for this one, for this mask with the shadow. And we're going to place this keyframe at the beginning. And at the end, I'm just also going to animate it towards the bottom, so it's completely animated off. And so one more thing that I want to do is bring back that Luma mat from our mask and bring it back into our track. And so here I want to press M on the keyboard and duplicate the mask and set it to subtract. And now press F on the keyboard and just feather the top mask right here. So if we solo this, we create something like this. And by feathering this, it's going to create some outlines here. And that's exactly what we want. And that's going to be some kind of glow. And we also want the other side. So we're also going to click here and expand it here. So I'm going to uncheck the expansion and just feather it quite a bunch. So that's something like that, a ring. And so I also want to bring my original footage on top once more. So click on your original footage, Control D, bring this all the way on the top and change this to an alpha mat. So we only see it wherever our character is. And so now I want to add a fractal noise, which I'm going to add a lot more contrast to, and that's going to give us that detail that we want right here, like a little bit of a magical effect. Change the fractal type to a dynamic progressive, and we can invert it to get a different look, and then play a little bit with the brightness if you want. Now we want to add a final tint effect, which is going to be blue. And that's going to be that blue kind of glow that is first disintegrating before the particles are really interacting. And just make sure that the mask expansion has a little bit of an offset. So we animated the mask expansion and make sure the second one just offset it a little bit to the right. So that's looking great. So one more thing that you could do is now select all of your particles together with the track, duplicate it, and then Control Shift C, particle displacement, to make them in a pre-comp and just call it particle displacement. So make sure the track is also duplicated and in there, and then make sure that they're still linked to that new track. And so if we go back now and we change this to a screen, or I'm not sure why, we can delete the shadow here. So if we change this to a screen, you see this, all right, so that means it has a black background. So what I wanna do here is go back in here and add an adjustment layer on top of this and add a tint effect. And on that tint effect, I wanna make sure that the blacks are all at 50%, okay? And I create a new solid layer and also set this to 50% black. And that just means it's not going to add any effect. So everything that is white is going to get displaced. So if we go back to our main comp and uncheck this layer and now create a new adjustment layer and add a displacement effect to this, it's a displacement map, let's say. We now have the option to choose that displacement map. And so you can see that it's affecting the displacement. And so if we set this to something like 25, we see displacement only being affected at that position. So there we go, we have now displacement. And so now on top of everything, I'm going to create a final adjustment layer and I'm going to make sure that it's not being track met, and I'm going to add a Lumetri color, which is going to be my colors. I'm going to increase the contrast a little bit, lower the shadows, maybe increase the colors. And so like that, we can start designing our final look. Okay, so there we have our grid. And then one more final adjustment layer, which is going to be one more glow pass. And yeah, after playing around a bunch, this is our final result. enjoyed it. If you did, give this video a like. Also, be sure to subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell to stay notified when I upload new videos. Apart from that, do check out Boris Effects with the link in the description. You can get 15% off any product using my coupon code. Apart from that, I hope to see you in the next one. Until then, create epic videos.